Hey there. Welcome to Life, Noggin. Hey guys, dinner is ready. It's all pizza bagels. Everything else was burned. Thanksgiving is typically filled with friends, family, food, and football. But during whatever festivities you take part in, it's important to remember that it's also one of the most dangerous times of the year. In addition to the high number of alcohol-related traffic accidents, according to the National Fire Protection Association, there are more home cooking fires on Thanksgiving than any other day. So you may want to rethink the turkey fryer. While your first instinct should be to call 911, if a fire does break out in your kitchen on Thanksgiving Day and you don't have access to water or a fire extinguisher, could you use any of that food to fight it? Please, do not try this for yourself. Seriously, but out of all the traditional Thanksgiving foods, gravy may be your best chance at putting out a fire due to its high water content. It's about 90% water and only around 5% carbohydrates, 3% proteins, and 2% lipids or fat. On the other hand, cranberry sauce may be a less than ideal choice. That's because it's only around 60% water, with carbohydrates, primarily sugar, making up the remaining 40%. And these carbs can affect how the water behaves. One of the main ways that water is used to put out fires is through heat absorption. As the water heats up and turns into steam, it absorbs heat from the burning material. Sugar and other dissolved chemicals increase the number of particles in water, causing it to boil at a slightly higher temperature than the normal 100 degrees Celsius. Theoretically, this could allow the water to absorb more heat. However, the increase is pretty minimal and nowhere near the temperature of fire, which is at least 525 degrees Celsius. Regardless, once the water is evaporated from the cranberry sauce, all that will be left are carbohydrates. And this could be extremely dangerous since carbohydrate particles are flammable and can even be explosive. We should note that water can be used only for fires of ordinary solid combustibles like wood and fabric. It should never be used on cooking oil and grease fires, as it will make things way worse. What are we supposed to do with this? There's so much of it. Those big tanker engines can hold 3,785 liters of water, which is equal to 3,785 kilograms. Since water and gravy weigh roughly the same, that's around 3,785 kilograms of gravy. Can you imagine the amount of turkey you could cover with all that? Speaking of turkey, as you're preparing your meal, you should take the right steps to stay safe. You should keep a fire extinguisher in the kitchen and not rely on gravy, store anything flammable away from the stove, keep kids or accident-prone adults away from anything hot or dangerous, and make sure your smoke alarms are working properly. And again, don't rely on gravy. The main cause of Thanksgiving Day fires is unattended cooking, so make sure you stay close to the food. So what's your favorite holiday dish that you could eat all the time? Let me know in the comment section below or tell me, what should I talk about next? Curious to know what would happen if you never stopped eating? Check out this video. One recent study found a significant relationship between added sugar consumption and an increased risk of dying from cardiovascular disease when observing participants for over 14 years. As always, my name is Blocko. This has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.